Hey there, and welcome to today's video where we will learn how to pull to refresh when using a list view or a list view builder. It works either way. In this case, we're going to use a list view. Very quickly, I will explain what's going on. This here is the flat button that's over here. This row is essentially just the two text fields, and then everything else is this square right here, which is populated by this list. And if I use control plus click, I go to the list, which is in the provider.dart file. And all that's here is a list and a function that essentially fetches the information that's stored in our database over here and applies it to this list and overrides whatever's here. I won't go into any explanation about this because obviously it deserves its own video, so let's get to it. So all you need to understand is that this list here right now is this. What we're going to do is get the list that I have stored here in this database right here using the SQLite Flutter package, which I have already populated with information. We'll make it show up here by pulling to refresh, and then we will add our own entry right here. We'll add it and we'll pull the refresh indicator again to see that it in fact refreshes. This is just something I made in a couple minutes to demonstrate how the pull to refresh works on Flutter. So what you do is you come over here to the first element in the body and you wrap it with a refresh indicator widget, and then besides the child it needs a on refresh property. Now what this expects is an anonymous function that returns a future. Make it async and then you return this function over here. And the way we do that is by typing in provider. Well, at least in this case, I'm using the provider package of context, and you specify the data type. This is essentially the class right here. That's the function. If you want to make it shorter, we can just do this and make it go straight like this. And this is pretty much it. If I restart the app and if I click to I forgot something very important here. You need to set it to listen to false, because we don't want listeners here at all. And now it should work. Let's see. And there it is. This is the database I had already previously populated. But now let's add something of our own. Let's add Jane. And she's, I don't know, 25. Now that I've added her, if I pull to refresh, there she is. And that's pretty much it, guys. So I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you learned something new today. If you did, do not forget to press that like button and subscribe to the channel to keep on learning everything related to Flutter. I would really appreciate it if you could support this channel and help me keep this going. So without anything else to add, this is Flutter Mentor and out.